嗨，大家好，3iAtlas 的最新更新图像来了，而且相当震撼。这不是普通的天文新闻，而是关乎我们最喜爱的神秘莱克，那颗从星际空间穿越而来的天体 3iAtlas， 它又有新动态了。说实话，这可能是最近太阳系内最值得关注的一次新发现。看好了，这就是 3iAtlas。你还记得我们上次聊它的时候吗？它悄悄绕过太阳，变得更亮更蓝，接着速度加快，像是打了鸡血一样往外窜。科学家当时怀疑这个所谓的非引力加速度从何而来，现在事情又有了反转。你猜怎么着？我们刚刚拿到了它的最新高清图像，这下子故事变得更怪更有意思了。我们本来以为像它这种出身星际的天体多半是颗典型的彗星，你知道的，拖着长长的尾巴，一路喷着气体，挥洒着尘埃，像个宇宙喷泉。但这张新图一出来，大家都愣住了，它居然没有尾巴。没错， 3iAtlas 在图像中完全看不出那种典型的彗尾结构，不是尾巴短，不是方向错了，而是根本没尾巴。这就好比看到一头鲸鱼却完全没有喷气孔一样，你会开始怀疑这到底是不是鲸鱼。为了帮我们解读这一幕颇具悬念的新发现，接下来让我们一起听听哈佛大学天文学家阿维·勒布教授昨天的最新访谈。
Yeah, that's very surprising because, there should have been a very massive cloud of gas and dust around it, based on what we know about comets. In fact, we see other, comets in the solar system that, have a beautiful tail away from the sun. Behind them, Lemon is an excellent example. But, in our case of, 3iAtlas,It looks like a fuzzy ball of light. Even after it passed through, perihelion, it was heated by 770 watts per square meter. We know that, the previous plume of gas was, mostly carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide ices, can sublimate at a much lower temperature than water ice. So we should have seen it break up.Or at the very least disintegrate to a very dense and massive cloud of gas and dust that is pushed away from the sun by the solar radiation and the solar wind. But we don't see that. So the question is, what's going on? One possibility is that what evaporates from it are fragments of ice, and they get vaporized by sunlight before they have a chance to turn around and show up as a plume of glow behind it, away from the sun. That's one possible interpretation, but otherwise I just don't know what to make of it. There was also a blue color that was noticed just a few days ago, and also in addition to that, it became brighter by a factor of five. So what I'm saying is,You know, there are things we don't fully understand about this object. That's what makes it exciting. And I think all of us will wait for the data that will come in the coming weeks. And especially on December 19th, when it comes closest to Earth. That's 6 days before Christmas. And let's hope we don't get unwanted gifts for our holidays. I think, you know, it's like a blind date with an interstellar object that came from an environment thatis alien to us. And I think the key question is whether it's natural or technological. The secondary question, if it's natural, what kind of an environment did it come from? Mm-hmm. It must be a common environment that produces large packages delivered to our mailbox. And we just need to find out the sender. Either way, it's thrilling. And it's really the reason why science is worthwhile doing, because we can gain new knowledge. And that goes against the tendencyof experts to pretend to be the adults in the room that know the answer in advance. Well, guess what? This object is telling the experts, think twice.
在他昨天发布的一篇文章中，标题就非常直接。在近日的观测图像中， 3iAtlas 没有明显的彗尾。文章里提到，在 3iAtlas 最接近太阳之后，科学家们从地面和太空望远镜拍下了一系列图像。结果令人惊讶， 这颗星际访客没有展现出任何清晰可见的彗尾结构。你可以想象，就像你满心期待要看到一列火车呼啸而过，结果却只看到一节安静驶过的车厢，后面什么都没有。勒布教授提出了几个值得深思的可能性。第一，三 I Atlas 的轨道非常接近太阳。按理说啊，如果它是冰雪构成的普通彗星，应该在高温作用下剧烈挥发，形成明亮尾巴。但图像却显示出它要么不太活跃，要么本身就没什么可喷发的物质。第二，颜色变蓝的现象，之前被认为是某种物质释放的信号，但现在看，也许只是表面反射或其他光学效应。第三，勒布教授提醒我们，正是这种不按常理出牌的现象，让科学不断前进。这可能是我们从未见过的新类型星际物体，不一定非要硬塞进彗星这个标签里。换句话说，三 I Atlas 也许根本就不是彗星，而是某种新物种。正当人们还在回味这颗无尾巴彗星的离奇表现时，勒布教授又在今天刚刚抛出新一弹。在他刚刚发布的最新文章中，公布了一张由火星轨道器拍摄的图像，是三 I Atlas 掠过火星轨道时的高清捕捉，使用的设备是著名的 HiRSE 超高分辨率相机，它通常用来拍摄火星表面，但这次特地对准了远方快速掠过的三 I Atlas。结果如何？勒布教授用了一个词，模糊 ,fuzzy。是的，影像模糊。但这并不意味着失败。要知道，这颗天体体积小，亮度低，飞行速度又快，要从火星轨道上拍到它，相当于在狂风中用望远镜捕捉一粒飘飞的沙子。图像虽然模糊，却再次验证，它没有明显彗尾，也没有喷发活动的迹象。这张图加强了之前的判断，也为后续的轨道分析提供了宝贵数据。更重要的是，它显示出我们的观测极限，以及我们和星际探索之间还隔着多远的距离。勒布教授指出，下一步，人类如果真想理解这些星际来客，就必须走出地球，走出火星，发射专门的探测器，去贴近他们，观察他们，甚至登陆他们。所以，一颗行为异常的星际天体，一个最新访谈，两篇新文章，一张新模糊图像，却留下了更多的疑问。三 I Atlas 究竟是什么？它真的是一颗沉默的星际彗星，还是某种我们从未命名过的宇宙访客？你怎么看？你认为它值得我们用探测器追出去吗？欢迎在评论区留下你的看法。如果你喜欢这样的宇宙探索故事，也别忘了点赞和订阅，我们会继续为你带来最新的星辰大海情报。这只是开始，更多故事还在太空深处。